BMX, a little bit of hip hop, and more BMX on today's sugarcane.com update. What's up, y'all? It's Crazy Al Kane. It's been a crazy week, a little bit more than a week since I posted the last update. It is now July 22nd, late afternoon, maybe evening time by the time I edit this all up. The bike of the day stuff has been going crazy. I even started a whole new competition. There's a lot more stuff than what's just posted on the front page, so I'm gonna have to kind of go through everything kind of quick just to get it all out. The first thing that we have featured on the site right now is this nice Daylight Arc C1, another dope build. This one sent in by Dave Molina, and it's the bike of the day. Today's bike of the day. Word up. So make sure you come to the site, rate this bike, give it a rating for the bike of the month competition. This month is crazy. We almost have 20 bikes this month. Definitely go there, rate his bike, tell your friend to tell a friend.
Tell a friend.
To rate this bike and all the other bikes that are listed for bike of the month, all right? If you didn't already know, USA BMX now has a freestyle division and they're sanctioning freestyle competitions, amateur freestyle competitions. So if you're an amateur BMXer from 5 years old all the way up until 40 plus, you can compete in the USA BMX freestyle competition. Since the whole Corona thing went down and shut stuff down, with a little bit of creativity, what they did is they created a virtual BMX series that they're doing for 2021. There's a lot of information about it on there, but it's really cool that they have that we have a sanctioned BMX freestyle organization, and it just brings me back to the days of AFA, American Freestyle Association, back in the 80s. So now we got something similar to that in 2021, so that's what's up. The other thing that's really cool about the sanction is that they have a 40 and over class. So there's a 40 and over masters class, so anybody who's an amateur that's 40 and over can actually compete in this, and they're gonna have a state championship, I believe, and also a national championship. Shout out to USA BMX for pushing the envelope and doing some new and creative things and stepping it up. BMX Bandits, son! Yeah, so BMX Bandits, I saw it on YouTube. Somebody posted the whole movie up on YouTube, and it's like crystal clear, like 4K quality. I made an article about the BMX Bandits. Nicole Kidman, you know, she started it. This was her first movie, actually. This was Nicole Kidman's first movie that she starred in. It's an Australian BMX classic. We also got it over here in the States back in the day. I think it was Cinemax or HBO that played it. This was one of the joints from back in the day, man. This was before Rad. This came out in 1983. Rad came out in 1986. And it was like more like a comedy, more like a Hollywood style movie. So it wasn't as edgy as, you know, as Rad was in comparison. But it still was a classic. There was some funny scenes, some good stunts. What I also found out when I was doing a little research on it was there's a whole bunch of different covers that they made for the film. I guess in different regions, different countries where it came out at, they made different covers for the DVD, the VHS, the CD. And I also found a very rare interview where Nicole Kidman actually mentions BMX Bandits. So it's pretty funny. She talks about it on the Graham Norton show. Graham Norton brings it up. And you can see her face right when he brings it up. And she was like, oh, here we go. Maybe one day we can get a real legit interview with Nicole Kidman talking about BMX Bandits. Closest thing we got is that Graham Norton interview. So definitely check out the article where I kind of go into all that stuff. So I finally got a 29-inch to feature on Bike of the Day. I've been asking people to send them 29-inch bikes in. I finally got one. I got sent this bike by Rick Corpus. He's down with a bike crew called the LA Rippers, out in LA, of course. And he sent this bike in and told me the story about how he used to ride around a beach cruiser, and it catches to make fun of him because they all had SE bikes. And then he finally got this Fast Ripper, got it flipped, converted, painted, and everything. And now he's like the man right now. So shout out to Rick and the LA Rippers for showing support to sugarcane.com Bike of the Day. And I want to see some more of those 29-inch bikes. And make sure you rate this bike and all the other bikes that are featured on Bike of the Day, all right? DC Shoes is flipping the script right now. They got a new sneaker called the Callus Volk. It's pretty dope. It's got a little unique style on the side. It's a DC skate shoe, so you know it's made to perform. Hopefully they can perform good on some flat pedals because we all about that flat pedal life. Speaking of flat pedals, Insight is making flat pedals now. It's got the Insight graphics on the pedal to give it some style. CNC machined, of course. You know it's from Insight, so the quality is going to be good. And so find out more about that on the website. We got this 2019 Mongoose Tidal Pro XXL sent in from Fred Melton. He done went and got the bike custom painted yellow. put some red decals on there, put some red parts on there, a little bit of chrome and polished parts on there, and made a really fresh bike of the day. This bike right here is definitely an original as far as paint and color scheme. When I first saw this bike on Facebook, I was like, dude, you gotta send me this bike to feature. So shout out to Fred for sending me this one. Make sure you come to the website and rate this bike for bike of the month. We got some really dope bikes, and this is definitely one of my favorites from this month. Next up, I got my dude Zav, the Zav. He actually was featured on Spittin' the Whip a couple years ago, but he is a BMXer, MC, stand-up comic, and he's also a world-renowned B-boy. He's a breakdancer. He has an album coming out, and his first single is called Do the Math, and he wanted to bring the culture of breakdancing and BMX into one video. It's real fresh when BMX and hip-hop cross paths. And Zav, just like myself, we grew up with BMX and hip-hop as part of our life, as part of our lifestyle, part of our culture. And there's a lot of other people out there like that, so it's always cool when you see a nice marriage of the two. Especially in this video, he's got the wheelie dudes up in there doing the wheelies while he's spitting bars and also breakdancing in the video. He represents the whole Philly scene. So we got all the Philly BMXers out there. See him doing that. He's doing flatland tricks and stuff in there. This is what the BMX hip-hop lifestyle is all about right here, man. Breakdancing, hip-hop, BMX, MCing. So it's real cool to see, you know, just that whole marriage right there. So that's what's up. So big up to my man Zav for doing this thing. And hopefully we can get him on one of the shows, do an interview with him, and talk about some BMX hip-hop. My dude G the promoter. I've been begging him and begging him and begging him to send me one of his builds, and he finally did. Bike of the day right here. This was bike of the day. It's a 2015 standard 125 RC 24 inch, and this bike is laced with some real premium parts. You know, Gino's all about keeping his bike tight, making it look fresh. You know, he's behind the whole Mid-Atlantic BMX. He's behind Raw Deal Tees. He also has his LRC team, the East Coast LRC team. He has a sick lineup of some custom builds, so this is just the first of many he's going to be sending. And just make sure you come back to sugarcane.com and rate his bike, give him a rating. I'm curious to find out which bike is going to make number one this month, the top bike for bike of the month. So next video will probably be an update of the next half of bikes that we got. Etnies got some dope sneakers. The Rockfield collection is pretty fire. I love the colors on these. Got the orange, got the white, the gray, and the black. It's definitely a dope sneaker. They made to perform. They got a whole lineup of stuff. If you go to their website, they got crazy sneakers. And this is just one of many that they have. These are the Rockfields. Definitely check those out. 09 is back doing their thing, son. They've been making apparel. They've been making the old school number plates. Now they got a 29-inch version of their Classic Works frame. And this is a complete. You can get it as a frame and fork, or you can get it as a complete. This is unlike any other 29-inch complete you can get. This 29 is laced with box parts. So it has top-of-the-line, high-quality parts on it all the way through. So it's got a ton of box parts, which means it's hella expensive. But you should not have to buy any other parts for this bike once you get it. This bike right here is fire. And it's real dope that 09 is back in the game. I always love their jerseys, and just their design looks are just fire, and they actually still hold up to this day. Look at that frame right there. It has the actual 09 graphic on there, which is just, it's a timeless look. The frame is chromoly, so all my chromoly heads out there, this right here is what you're looking for. So shout out to 09. Definitely check out the details on the article. Come to sugarcane.com. Check out the details and the articles. If you haven't seen it already, I did an unboxing video for the Supercross Retro Ray bobblehead. If you're a BMXer who's into collecting bikes and toys, or just a toy collector who happens to like BMX, this is definitely something you want to add to your collection. But check out my unboxing. It's on the website. Shout out to Supercross again for not only being a high-end, super high-end BMX company, but also a company that knows how to have fun and do different things at the same time. So big up. And the last bike featured on the front page of sugarcane.com today, at least, is this 1998 Specialized Fatboy A1 Cruiser sent in by Mark Peterson. This bike right here is so clean, so fresh, bringing that 1998 style in. They made some dope innovative bikes back then. It's a shame they're not in the game no more for BMX, but you can always reminisce with this 1998 Specialized, right? So this was Bike of the Day a couple of days ago. Definitely go and rate this bike. I want to find out who's going to win this Bike of the Month thing, okay? So what I do, just in case you don't know, is I have a Bike of the Day series that I do where I feature a bike. I try to feature one every day. People submit their bikes in, they send me the picture, they send me the inspiration for their build, and they send me a full parts list. We put it up on the site, we feature it, we have people rate the bike, and by the end of the month, whatever bike has the top rating, the highest rated bike, wins Bike of the Month. So that's pretty much how that works out. So if you have a BMX bike, whether it's a 20-inch, 16-inch, a 29-inch, anything in between, make sure you send it, take some good pictures of your bike, and if you like it, we gonna post it. So some of y'all might know, some of y'all might not know, I made a competition called the Battle of the Big City Rippers. SC Bikes has been coming out with all of these city themed BMX bikes. They got four right now. They got the LA Ripper, the New York City Ripper, the Philly Ripper, and the Miami Ripper. So I was like, you know what, let me make up this competition called the Battle of the Big City Rippers. So what you do is you come to the website and you check out the bikes and you can rate them. I have a chart that I made where you can actually see what the current breakdown is. So on this page right here, the Big City Ripper Battle page, you can see the chart of the bikes and where they rank. So starting from the left is the number one bike, which is the New York City Ripper. So as of today, July 22nd, New York City Ripper is a top rated bike with a 9.49. It has 11 votes, but 11 people think that this bike is fire. So overall, they gave it a 9.49 rating, all right? Next up is the Miami Ripper, 37 votes, but people gave it an 8.97. So it's not just about the amount of votes you give, it's also about how high you rate the bike. It's really about the rating. If a lot of people start rating your bike and start bringing the rating up, it can still go up. Coming in third place with an 8.81 overall rating is the Philly Ripper, which had 16 votes. Between the color combo, overall style, and collectible status, it got an 8.81. So you have to rate those criteria. Once you rate those criteria, it gives it an overall rating, and that's how you find out what the overall rating is, and then you'll see where they wind up on the actual list. And coming in fourth place is the LA Ripper. 15 votes, and it got an 8.23 rating. Right now, New York City's winning. It's number one, and I'm gonna keep this chart going until the last Big City Ripper comes out. And I think there's more coming, so stay tuned for that. Now, speaking about competitions, let's talk about the Bike of the Month chart. So these are the top four Bike of the Day bikes battling for Bike of the Month. And right now, we got that 1998 Robinson Pro XL at number one with a 9.73 rating. It got 30 votes, and 30 people thought that this bike was fire. Next up, we got that 4NYX with a 9.68 rating. It's got 81 votes, a lot of votes. But the consensus as far as the ratings go, it's a 9.68, all right? That's what the people are saying. Next up is we got that dope Mongoose, got 24 votes, and it's got a 9.57 rating. So that's what the people are saying, man. Overall, the consensus of everybody voting, they're saying this bike is a 9.57. And then in fourth place, we got that custom Daylight Arc C1 with a 9.52 rating. It's got 42 votes, but the consensus of people, everyone together, all the votes combined together, it comes in at a 9.52. Now, if you're watching this at home and you're like, nah, that bike needs to be in first place, this one needs to be in third, whatever, 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 then you need to go and let your voice be heard. Go on the website. If you click right on these little titles right here and you scroll down just like that, you scroll down to where it says rate this bike, right here, and you can see the box right here. It tells you right now what the overall score is, how many people rated the bike. Actually, 35 people voted on this bike since we've been on. And this is where you can leave your rating. And all you gotta do is use the sliders. You slide them up, slide them down, and you can rate between 0 and 10. We have like about 17 bikes that are listed for July Bike of the Day. So you can actually go on there and rate all the bikes. So that way, you can get your opinion heard on all of those bikes, all right? And definitely leave a comment. Let me know why you are, why you rated the bike the way you did. You know, come to sugarcane.com. You can scroll down some more. You can actually leave your emoji reactions as well, just for fun. And then you can come down here and leave your comments. And you just put your comments in and let us know why you rated it that way or whatever information you want to send us. So that's pretty much it for this week. I'm going to be doing another one next week, most likely. We're going to be posting up a lot more stuff, a lot more information. I got more original content coming. Another one of those bunny hop face-off competitions coming. I'll be posting more beats. I might even do some parodies. I know I keep talking parodies, but eventually there'll be a parody. Subscribe to the website, hit that notification button, show me some love, send me some comments, comment on this, let me know what you think about this. Let me know what you think about this series of update videos that I'm doing. If you like them, if you don't like them, or whatever the case is. That's pretty much it. It's Crazy Al Kane, sugarcane.com, CACTV. This is the Sugarcane Update, and
back to you, Billy.